all the tears from down your face. Use us to ease your pain today. They're only words. I write late at night for you. Please don't cry your smile away. Oh, 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 oh.
I don't even care what the fuck y'all think about this attire because I'm freezing cold. So after my ranting and rambling, this is probably the best video I've ever fucking made. I actually have a song that I sang, and I may post that on here if I fucking feel like it. Getting down to the nitty gritty. There is some motherfucking man out there. And trust me when I say this shit reaches from the east coast of North Carolina, Outer Banks, to the west coast as far as Hawaii. There goes that damn phone. If you don't like my videos, don't fucking watch them. It's that simple. Another thing, if you don't like drugs, like I don't do drugs, I don't like drugs, don't fucking do them. If you do not like gay marriage, don't marry a gay person. Get a fucking life. And stop judging other people. Because if you have nothing better to do with your time than to judge other people, anytime you're pointing a finger at somebody, there's about four or five pointing back at you. So don't even go down that fucking road. Because everybody already knows how fucking pathetic you already are. If you cannot deal with someone like me who tells the truth constantly, then go the fuck on somewhere. Nobody gives a shit about you. I'm telling you what, I gotta cut this shit short. The mere act of speaking is getting on my fucking nerves now. Not to mention the fact that this guy that I'm talking to just texted me. So, considering the fact that he is not like most of the fucking nincompoops out there that I'm talking to, or the fucking so-called friends who actually are fair-weather friends, or mere acquaintances, or backstabbers, or members of my family who are just so fucking disgusting and pathetic all by itself. Honey, I'm telling you, you want somebody who's real, who's in your face, who is nice all the fucking time, who will blow up every so often like I'm doing right now, and you always know the fucking truth, then you need to fucking contact me. Anybody else? I don't have anything to say to you. I have absolutely nothing else to say to you. Or nothing to say to you to fucking even begin a conversation. So, unless you have a life of your own and you're not judging others, and you don't think you're better than everybody else, yeah, sure, you can contact me. The rest of you motherfuckers can take a goddamn hike, because I do not even fucking care. I live my day with God. Every day with God. If you're atheist and all that shit, I've heard it all fucking before. Take a fucking hike somewhere. Nobody cares. Hey babies, I'm back. It is January 27th, 2015, 4:06 p.m. Brand new day. Sucks equally as much as the past fucking month has. So, what did you guys think about my sex video? Well, not my sex video, because I would never show you that. What I mean to say is, what did you guys think about my video on the topic of my sex life? I was a little drunk when I made that, so I can imagine. I wasn't actually drunk. I had just had a beer, an entire 40-ounce beer, or so. So the dude that I was talking to you guys about, who wanted to keep me and his ex-girlfriend on the hook together so he could have his cake and eat it too, has decided to drop me entirely, which I'm fucking grateful for. But only after he called and asked me to pay for his vehicle, which the day before he had totaled, because he was fucking high and on every other kind of drug probably, and drunk, and pulls out in front of someone with his father in the car with him. So, the whole front of his vehicle's totaled. Of course, he calls and asks me for the money, and I'm like, right. So my new tenant is here. If you would please give me a fucking second. This is probably going to take a little bit, so bear with me. So it is now 4:42 p.m. That is how long-winded my new tenant is. I got rid of that other motherfucker. He was crazy, honey. Oh my god, and I'm going to tell you about him too. Anyway, I got a good Christian fellow in here now, so, and he's really cool. That little motherfucker who tried to, like, hang on to myself and his ex for the longest time, and of course she broke up with him the next fucking day, from what I found out from him. And then, of course, the next day he crashed his fucking car, and the next day he was calling me, asking me to help him get his fucking car out. Well, he purchases up today, which is 2 days later, after he called asking, actually 3 days later, after he called asking me for money, and tells me that I don't do anything but ramble in my videos. And I'm sitting here thinking, this is a fucking diary, dude. If you don't want to hear what the fuck is going on in my life, don't listen to it. You know, I'm not forcing you to listen to it. But if you have such a problem with it, how is it that you know what I say word for fucking word? I mean, it's obvious you've not just watched them once, but you're watching them repeatedly. Because you're trying to see me from a fucking distance. I mean, dude, grow the fuck up. Seriously? No. Mm-mm. Sister's not gonna put up with that shit. And speaking of sisters, my sister, what is going on with people? What? I mean, I really wish someone could give me a diagnosis of what the fuck is going on with people. My sister is shoved so far up at D's asshole. Suddenly, we're not on speaking terms again. I have no fucking idea why. I texted her all the other day to see if she was okay. Which, whatever. Apparently, she doesn't fucking care about me because she's not texting asking me that. Unless she wants something. Okay, so then I call her phone and her boyfriend or my nephew. Let me backtrack for a second. I called my mother first. And she's like, I'm not seeing your sister in days. So of course I'm trying to find out what the fuck's going on. So I call her phone and someone picks up the phone, which is not her, because I hear her in the background talking about, quote, I do not want to talk to that bitch. And her, whoever asks who it is on the phone, and she's like, my sister, Jessica. And I'm sitting here thinking, bitch, I have not done shit to you. I don't know what the fuck. And this is like a day after I threw my roommate out. Give me a second. My other one's back. truckers out there who do need to hear it, do not contact me when you need me. Your ass is done. That goes for my exes, my ex-best friends. There is some bitch posting shit online about me constantly on Craigslist because I am trying to rent my home, which you all already know. I discuss it constantly. This bitch wants to post shit on there about me, like, taking advantage of disabled people and blah, 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 blah. Get a fucking life. Alright, boys. So, anyway, girls, children. He gave me some good advice. So, that, like, broke up the... Bear with me for a second. Sorry. He gave me some good advice. So, that calmed me the fuck down. Can't beat that. At any rate, I'm going to give y'all some advice. For you women out there, I understand exactly where you're coming from. Especially in the town I live in, presently. I have never in my life dealt with such a dumbfounding amount of men who think that their fucking shit does not stink and that they can have any woman that they want, or treat women like trash. I have never in my life seen men who disrespect women the way that the motherfuckers in this town disrespect women. Honestly, I would say the Tri-County area. I have never been so disrespected before in my life. I don't know where that shit begins. I don't know when the shit is going to end. But I am telling every single one of you men that there are some women out there that will deal with that shit. I have seen it. My best friend's husband beats the shit out of her and she doesn't want to even fucking tell anybody. So I know you're out there. I, on the other hand, if you put your fucking hands on me, you better hope and pray that you come out fucking alive. Because I've suffered that shit. And trust me, if you're not learning from your fucking mistakes, you're dying in them. And I refuse to do that. I'm going to go ahead and tell all you little motherfuckers around here that want to hook up with me and shit like that. This shit about Kyle Jessica and make all these false promises and promise the moon and you don't deliver shit. You can forget that shit. I see straight through that shit now. I have seen straight through that shit since my ex pulled the bullshit of putting his hands on me. I'm telling you, for you little motherfuckers out there that when... This dude, I'm telling you what, and I know this motherfucker is listening to my videos. Wants to start on Meet Me. That's where I met this motherfucker. Brought a cab to pick his ass up for New Year's. He's actually the person who gave my New Year's kiss to me. So... I picked you up in a fucking cab, and you know who you are. He disappears for like 2 weeks, and is apparently in the background of his brain, he's like watching all of my fucking videos, watching every move that I make on every networking site that I have, like these little fucking snakes in the grass do, and, he's watching every fucking move I make, and he texts me one day, or starts talking shit to me on Meet Me one day, and I'm like, what the fuck? I was nothing but nice to you. I didn't do shit wrong to you. He starts, like, posting all this shit about me, all these bad things, and I'm like, I just overlooked it. Even to up and unto the point when he decides he's going to tell me that he is going to post my phone number all over these networking sites. See that, and calling me a whore and shit like that, and I'm like, what the fuck? Where the hell is this shit coming from? People have no fucking backbone anymore. If I have a fucking problem with you, like had I had a problem with him, which I didn't even know fucking existed, and there goes my phone. Had I had a problem with him, I would have told him to his fucking face. I didn't have a fucking problem with him. Suddenly, he sees me one night acting like asking me if I want to be in a relationship and all this shit, and then 2 weeks later, he's wanting to post my number all over the internet, and I'm like, dude, go right the fuck ahead. That is more subscribers for me. I don't know what the fuck your problem is, but honey, I am here to tell you, every single one of you out there, bitches, fucking assholes, men, women, it don't fucking matter, friends, foes, it does not matter. For those of you who do know me, I am not a bitch you want to fuck with. You have got the wrong goddamn one. It is that simple. I will rip your fucking life to shreds. In a heartbeat. I have had friends stab me in the back. This motherfucker's sitting here telling me he's gonna post my number all over the internet. I'm like, good, motherfucker, that's more subscribers for me. You're a fucking idiot. You know? God always wins. Good always wins. Have none of you motherfuckers ever heard the expression that cheaters never win? If you're cheating at any kind of game, you're not going to fucking win. It's that goddamn simple. So I suggest you take your head out of your own asshole and look at the world around you and see that there are people out there like me who are non-judgmental, who are going to tell you the fucking truth all the time. If you can't deal with the fucking truth, continue to live your life in misery. I don't fucking care. But you're certainly not going to drag me down with you. This shit is not going to fucking happen because I will look you square in the fucking eye and tell you, I know you're lying. I know you're being deceptive. You don't even fucking live in a world of reality. You are living in this fucking fantasy world, and I do not care to live there with you. I have my own shit to deal with, and trust me when I say, I do not want it to be anywhere near as complex as the shit that you're dealing with. You are writing a book for yourself that, Lord have mercy, people. Seriously, they got this bitch on a rampage today. Good. Because some of you little motherfuckers out there need to hear it. I'm telling y'all what, the life of a grown woman is nothing to fuck around with. This is good. God. Oh. At least the new tenant that I have and myself are on the same page. And y'all can't even see how immaculate my eyes look today because my fucking hair is in the way. So anyway, 4:50 p.m. January 27th. 2015. I can't even believe I've lived this fucking long, honestly. I'm surprised I'm not 6 feet underground. With that, oh my god. So much shit. Shit, just shit. I literally had to fucking ask. Some dude, I am in the process of losing my home. Yay! Because I'm sick of this fucking place altogether. I'm in the process of losing my home, and I don't even fucking care. And the reason for that is because of my aunt's irresponsibility. Not only has the state, or the county, I suppose, decided to try to auction off my fucking house in the short period of time since one of the last videos I made and told you about the beginnings of this snowball that's going straight towards hell. Of course, I've learned today from my attorney that that will take a significant amount of time. Not only has that happened, but apparently, when I told you that my house is on a loan with another house, my aunt has not been fucking paying that either. So, And I told you that that's exactly what I had expected from the entire situation. I'm not even upset about it. Ultimately, it excites me. At any rate, and not to mention the fact I met this new guy, and he is fucking great, man. Fucking great. Completely open-minded, open to anything. I love it. Role-playing, all that shit. But I'm not going to snatch back onto that sex shit. What I'm going to tell you is that this guy calls me from the bank today, and he's like, I need to come estimate your house to see how much your aunt can sell it for. And I'm like, the bitch ain't selling my fucking house. You're crazy. I will burn this motherfucker down to the ground before that happens. Of course, that's completely facetiously speaking. At any rate, this house that I live in was in condemnation when I bought it from my aunt. And I didn't even realize that. Nor did I realize that she owed, at the time, $10,000-some-odd in taxes on this house, which has, by the way, accrued to $12,000-some-odd in taxes, which she owes on my fucking house. So, at any point in time, like I had said before, they can snatch my fucking house away from me. The good news is, I have learned from my attorney that even if the bank forecloses on her loan, which includes another house, that if I do not buy both houses at the same time, then I'm going to lose my house. So, I'm sure you know how thrilled I am about that shit. All the money I've put into this motherfucker, it is not cheap to redo a house. I'm sure there are many of you out there who are in the construction industry, and you know that the shit ain't cheap. A fucking gallon of paint now costs $40-some-odd if you want to get good paint that's not going to wear off in a week's time. So, with me painting 6 rooms of a house, you can imagine how much money I've spent. With me repairing wood that is rotted on the outside of my house, you can imagine how much money I've spent. With me having to practically fill in a chimney, you can imagine how much money I have spent on this fucking house. That's what pisses me off. So, if the shit gets sold, I will be compensated for the time and the money that I have spent keeping this house from being knocked down into the dust of the earth, because that is exactly what they were going to do. I couldn't even move into my house for the first month I had it, because it had to pass code for the city. Who the fuck buys a house that you cannot immediately move into? I mean, to move my clothes in, I want to move all my fucking belongings into. Blah, 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 blah. If any of you know of a decent attorney that does real estate, of course, my attorney is great, but we do criminal law. That's something totally different. There are attorneys that master in all different types of situations. Criminal law, civil law. You have district attorneys who know about all kinds of law and who are good at all of those. You have real estate attorneys. You have all different kinds of attorneys. They all have a niche, which means that they focus on different aspects of law. There are a few attorneys that focus on a couple of different aspects of law. Like, there can be a real estate attorney who does civil law and criminal law, but there is very few and far between, because, trust me, I do criminal law, which means I can get practically anybody off. I will not do that, but I can. And that's a headache all by itself. At any rate, my new roommate just called me and was like, do you need anything? Blah, 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 blah. He is so sweet. We're on the same page. I was like sitting here wishing, I wish this motherfucker would call me and be like, you don't have to do this, that, or the other. Just let me take care of you. Because I'm telling you, the devil, evil itself, is up my fucking asshole today. I have dealt with one thing directly after the next. In fact, for the past week, my phone has not stopped fucking ringing. And you all know how I feel about text and my phone ringing and doing all this. And not to mention the fact I need to call my phone company because apparently my phone will pop up and say you have a voicemail message. And I'm like, nobody even fucking called. What are you talking about? So, give me a second. I'm going to tell y'all what. That little psycho ex motherfucking roommate that I had, the tenant, that I told you was crazy, shoving fucking Q-tips and shit up his cat's vagina so she would go out of heat, which didn't fucking work. Trust me when I say, if somebody shoved anything in my vagina when I am in heat, the last thing I'm going to do is try to go out of it or end it in any way, shape, or form, because that shit feels good as fuck. So anyhow, after I threw his fucking ass out, let me tell you what happened the night before. One of his cats came up missing. Imagine the fact that it was the one that he was having sex with or doing whatever the fuck you want to call that bestiality bullshit. Anyhow, she comes up missing. And I'm completely to fucking blame. Even though you've all seen my videos over the past month. And this motherfucker, I come home after going to the store for 30 minutes. And my dog is missing. He's standing out at the fucking road, the tenant, not the dog, and tells me that we no longer have a dog. And I'm thinking, we? What the fuck are you talking about? We? I'm not even in any kind of a relationship with you. I don't even fucking like you. So anyhow, he's telling me we don't have a dog. And I'm like, what the fuck is going on here? Honey, miraculously, in the 30 minutes time frame that I was going to the store to buy groceries, the fucking back door opened itself and my dog escaped the house. Which does not thrill me at all. So I didn't get an attitude, I didn't say anything. I was like, well, if that's what God wants the dog to do, fine. So anyhow, a couple days later, one of his cats comes up missing. He finds it. End of story. The next couple days, another cat comes up missing. Because people come in and out of my fucking house religiously. So his other cat comes up missing. And I'm like, I do not fucking care about your goddamn cats. I don't fucking care. They're inbred. I don't want fucking nothing to do with them at all. I do not want anything to do with your fucking cats. They're equally as inbred as you are. You make me fucking sick. I wish you would just leave. So, this motherfucker has the damn nerve to start texting me from the other room. Not even like 10 feet away, 20 feet away from me in my house. And I'm like, motherfucker, if you want to talk to me, you need to perch your ass up in here and say that shit to my face. So he comes in here and starts telling me that shit I was telling y'all before about the compulsive liar and all this shit. And I'm like, dude, what the fuck ever. You live in your fantasy world. Fine. I don't fucking care about that. I care about that as much as I do about your animals. So anyhow, he proceeds to tell me that those cats are like his children. Imagine that crazy shit. But my dog was not even mine. That it was not like a child to me. And anyways, I had to cut his ass off at the fucking pass, honey. I was like, that fucking dog was as important to me as those fucking cats are to you. And the dog was an inbred. He at least had some intelligence. And a tremendous degree of intelligence, mind you. And you let my fucking dog out. So yeah, of course I'm going to be pissed. And I was like, if you got something to fucking say to me, you need to say that shit to my face. You don't need to be fucking passively, aggressively texting me, because I'll whip your fucking ass. It's that simple. I wanted to whip his ass. I wanted to fly up out of my bed at 1 o'clock in the morning when he comes in slamming doors and shit telling me his cat had disappeared. Who gives a shit? You know, I do not fucking care. I didn't give a shit when they fucking moved in, and I don't give a shit now. This is the motherfucker that has got his hands. I swear to God. If y'all have ever watched The Peanuts, Charlie Brown, all that shit is The Peanuts. With Lucy. I'm definitely Lucy. I'm telling you. This motherfucker would have his hands in my fucking fish tanks. And told me that fish needed to be massaged and touched and all this. Meanwhile, I don't have gravel in my fish tanks. I have sand. Because fish don't have fucking gravel in the real world, in their environment. They have sand. At any rate, he stirred up the fucking sand in my fish tank to the point, in one of my fish tanks, to the point that it stopped up the goddamn filter. Well, the next day, he's in there and he's like, the filter's broken, it's not sucking through. Well, I can't imagine why, considering the fact that it's filled up with goddamn sand. Hello? It took me a little bit to figure that out too and put two and two together because I wasn't trying to deal with it. At any rate, I was like, leave the fucking filter alone. Keep your goddamn hand out of my fish tank. You have your own fucking fish. Go stir around in their tank. Leave my shit alone. Everything that this motherfucker touched turned into pure chaos. I am not kidding. I could make a meal and he would eat over half of it. 3/4 of it. I barely got anything. And I didn't say a fucking word about it. But when it comes to you dealing with my animals and like, just trying to like fuck up my animals' environment, I'm sitting here racking my brain trying to determine why the fuck my filter all of a sudden stopped working. Well, the day before that, a heater had stopped working in one of my tanks, which froze half of my fish to death. And I'm not real thrilled when my fish die. The reason for that is I raise betas and I raise cichlids. So, if you fuck up their environment, it's fucked. They're not gonna breed. I can't make money off of dead fucking fish. Lord have mercy, y'all, I'm telling you. I'm on a fucking rampage today, and I love it. Half of these videos that I'm posting today, I swear I've probably posted or put up 10 videos or made 10 of them. I am fucking sick of every goddamn body. I'm telling you, I have had it. These motherfuckers come into your life and start complete chaos. I'm to the point now that I don't even want to have fucking friends at all. I didn't want anybody around me. The only people that I do want around me are the few close friends that I do have. And there's like two of them. And my mother. Of course, my mother. She's got to be in my life. That's it. I didn't want to deal with family. I did not want to deal with these so-called fair-weather friends or acquaintances. Thank God that I am not a fucking sniper. My ex was good at that shit. Because he was in the military. I am glad that I never learned to use a gun that well. I hope that I never do.